we are asked to complete the table. In the first row, we're given 25 raised to the 1/2 power, which is the exponent form. We're asked to give the root form, the root of a square, and the simplified form. The main thing to remember here is that x raised to the 1/2 power equals the square root of x. In general, when we have a fractional exponent, a rational exponent, the denominator of the exponent gives us the index, the numerator gives us the exponent on the radicand. So more specifically, for the square root, the index is 2, matching the denominator, and the exponent on x is 1, matching the numerator of the exponent. But as long as we remember x to the 1/2 equals the square root of x, we can complete the table. So 25 raised to the 1/2 power is equal to the square root of 25. For the root of a square, because 25 is equal to 5 times 5, which equals 5 squared, we can write this as the square root of 5 squared. And when simplifying a square root, we're looking for a non-negative number times itself that gives the radicand, and therefore the simplified form is 1 factor of 5. The square root of 5 squared equals 5, the square root of 25 equals 5, and so does 25 raised to the 1/2 power. In the next row, we're given the square root of 121. In exponent form, we would have 121 raised to the 1/2 power. 121 is equal to 11 times 11, which equals 11 squared. And therefore, the root of a square is the square root of 11 squared. And therefore, the simplified form is 1 factor of 11. And finally, here we're given the square root of 7 squared. Well, 7 squared is equal to 7 times 7, which equals 49. So the root form is the square root of 49. And therefore, the exponent form is 49 raised to the 1/2 power. And all three of these simplify to 1 factor of 7. I hope you found this helpful.